Hey guys, it's Cloudhaven. Alright, so we're going to talk about this Vanity Fair article with Jennifer Lawrence. Especially this particular part that unnerved a lot of people on the internet, but it also unnerved me a little bit. There's a lot of people in Hollywood. Jennifer Lawrence has kind of been a little out there. She blew up, for all y'all that don't know about Jennifer Lawrence. She blew up with the Hunger Games back in 2012. Mockingjay and Mockingjay 2 and the last one or whatever. Viola Davis and her are having an interview. It was quite lengthy. I'm not going through the whole thing. But I want to play something particularly for you guys to kind of give you guys. I'll just play it. So listen carefully, and I'll play it back too.
Circle back to you being the lead of Woman King, and we're at, I think it's 94% on Rotten Tomatoes, 66 million domestic.
All right, remember that number, 66 million domestic, right? Okay, we're at 66 million domestic, right? So, just keep that number in mind. Now, here we go.
It is just, it couldn't have been more wrong. I thought it was so, I just love seeing stories like that of, I remember when I was doing Hunger Games, nobody had ever put a woman in the lead of an action movie.
Did you hear that? When I was on the set of doing Hunger Games. Let's hit that back again.
I remember when I was doing Hunger Games, nobody had ever put a woman in the lead of an action movie because it wouldn't work.
Because it wouldn't work. Nobody had ever put a female in the lead of an action movie because it couldn't work. Okay. Blank face lie. Obviously, it's made to trigger people, but let's listen to a little bit more.
We were told, girls and boys can both identify with a male lead, but boys cannot identify with a female lead. And it just makes me so happy every single time I see it.
So, let's, so you guys can hear it again. Let's go back and hear it again. And before we continue on, go ahead and hit that like and subscribe for me. If you like what I do in content, I do games, what have you. I do news, politics. I touched on Lord of the Rings, Rings of Power, I touched on a little bit of House of Dragon. So if you guys like what I do, if you like what I offer, please go ahead, hit that like and subscribe button. So we're going to get right into this. And, you know what? Scratch that. Here's the proof. Here's the proof that she's a bold-faced lie. Oh, y'all forget about Tomb Raider 2001. When did Hunger Games come out? 2012, right? Here's also how much it made. Alright. It released in 2001, right? Lara Croft, Tomb Raider, Angelina Jolie, female-led this action star. Not to mention, she's got a few others like Mr. and Mrs. Smith, co-lead. So that right there, false narrative, right? Don't believe everything Hollywood says. Look at this. Remember, Woman King is at 66 million right now, right? As of today, right? Tomb Raider grossed a total of 274,733,304 worldwide. 161,168,070 domestic, right? So that alone proves, and it shows you, and it gives you a breakdown, right? And this is from Box Office Mojo, okay? Powered by IMDb Pro. So, and you guys know IMDb is pretty reputable. Okay, next example. Oh, also, we're also forgetting another good banger, Wanted. When did this release? I don't know. Before 2012. How about 2008? Female led. Angelina Jolie. Gross $134,508,551 domestic. Worldwide, $342,463,063 worldwide. Right? So that already blows out the water that the narrative that they talk about women-led movies can't work. And women-led movies don't make money. Bullshit. Next example. How about Little Assassin Hannah? Oh, when did this release? I don't know. A year before Hunger Games. 2011. She was raised to be an assassin. Perfect-led movie. Oh, get this. Okay, so look. This made domestic $40,259,119 domestic, right? Worldwide, $63,782,078. So, and this was before Hunger Games. Now, see, here's the thing, right? And I got more receipts. I got a couple more receipts I want to bring forward. Oh, what about this banger? Kill Bill. Y'all can't tell me that Uma Thurman didn't do that thing. She didn't do that thing playing Beatrice Kiddo? Come on now. You tripping, Jennifer Lawrence. You tripping, man. Kill Bill is probably one of the arguably most famous movies for a female-led, I don't know, in the 2020s, the 2010s, excuse me, the 2010s and the 2000s. You tripping. This came out in 2003, right? Already, $79,045 domestic, worldwide $180,906,076. And you forget, not to mention we got volume 2 and 3. So I don't get it. Okay, this narrative, and you know what? I got another one. And here's the thing. Before, what was her statement? Before Hunger Games, right? These are all titles and movies before Hunger Games that made shit tons of money, right? So then we also got Mila Jovovich. You cannot tell me she has not led several female-led movies, and this is just one of them. Right, we got Resident Evil that came out in 2001, right? And I didn't want to do a whole bunch. I'm just giving y'all some examples. I don't want to keep y'all too long, but I just want to prove to y'all, yo, Jennifer Lawrence is tripping, man. She's tripping hard. So, get this, right? Oh, wait, excuse me, my bad. I got you, though. Right? This didn't make that much because it wasn't all that known, it wasn't all that popular, but hey, it still made a decent amount. So it works. It made It made a little bit over, but hey, that's why I'm giving y'all all different levels, right? We also gonna bring up woman queen. We can't bring up woman kings gross yet because we don't know officially. I don't think it's wrapped up. But I'm gonna look at that. We also gonna look at Hunger Games, right? And how much they made, and we're gonna pair them back to some of my examples. So we got 18,535,812 domestic. We got worldwide 31,070,211, right? So, hey, it didn't really get too, you know, but this was a female led movie that came out in 2006, right? All right. So let's see what Woman King's got. 2022. We got the gross. And I thought it wouldn't be out just yet. I thought they were gonna keep it pushing. So we're gonna look at where it's at. We're gonna look at how it ended. And all over. Let's see. Let's look at the United Kingdom. Okay, so domestic. So we had 19 million on opening, and we had 67 million gross so far, right? That's domestic, right? So then domestic, we got $67,113,157, right? Then we got worldwide $92,213,157. So you telling me that these female-led movies don't work? That's bullshit. Get the hell out of here with that. And also, we're going to compare the examples. So we got Wanted. Wanted, $342 million, right? So that's higher than Woman King. And the point is not to bring about what's higher than Woman King or not and what have you. We're gonna also address Hunger Games. Don't get it twisted. Okay, so we got $63 million for Hannah. And that means their budget. So they're positive. Just about all of these movies are positive. Even if they didn't make that much, they're positive. So that means they work. They just got to have a compelling story and the marketing behind it. Just like with the man movies, there's tons of men's movies out there that don't get the marketing, that don't have the marketing, but also don't get the popularity, right? So that we got Hannah at 63. We got Kill Bill at 180, and that's not even counting the other ones. Right? So we can add all those up if we want to, right? So they work. So that narrative that these female leads don't work, right? All right. So let's go back. We got Hunger Games. And this is why I'm providing you context too. So we're going to go with the first one in 2012, right? All right. So this made over a quarter, about a little bit over half towards $1 billion, right? So I don't get why she's saying that there weren't any female-led movies. But let's go back just a little bit more of what this. Don't get me started.
Certain people out of the movies, keep certain people in the same positions that they've always been. It's just amazing to watch it happen, watch you at home. My God.
So, that's all I really want to touch on this. So, guys, if you like what I do, if you want to see more of this, if you want to see me call up nonsense, let me know in the comments below. So, we're going to end it with you. And this is Cloud Haven. All right, y'all.